This video is brought to you by Ridge Wallet, a slim front pocket wallet available in carbon fiber and titanium. With more than 250,000 sold, a lifetime guarantee and free shipping, get 10% off with the code GOLDFISH at RidgeWallet.com. Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Instant Deck Tech. So as you know, Thursday means it's Fishbowl Thursday here in Instant Deck Tech land, and this week we have an incredibly spicy Pauper deck. This is Zubera, but not just Zubera, Zubera Storm comes to us from the aptly named Storm, so thanks Storm for submitting a super cool Pauper deck. A quick reminder before we break down Zubera Storm for Pauper. If you want your own deck considered for a future edition of Fishbowl Thursday, make sure to leave a link in the comments or you can email it to me, saffronolive@mtggoldfish.com. Anyway, let's talk about this crazy Zubera Storm deck. So unlike the modern deck we played that was just tons of Zubera, this deck only has two different Zubera and only a total of five copies of those Zubera. So we have four Floating Dream Zubera, probably better known as the Card Draw Zubera, and one Ember Fist Zubera, the Damage Zubera. So the idea of this deck isn't to play a ton of different Zubera. Instead, we're trying to play the same Zubera or the same couple Zubera a whole bunch of times. So to make this deck work, we need to be able to kill our own Zubera, because Zuberas trigger when they die. Floating Dream Zubera dies, you draw a card equal to the number of Zuberas that have died this turn. Ember Fist Zubera, same thing but for damage. So for this, we have Viserysir in Bloodthrown Vampire. So Viserysir is our main sack outlet. Really good because it lets us scry as we're sacking to find the rest of our combo pieces, keep the combo going, and eventually get what is essentially a Storm-style kill. Bloodthrown Vampire, on the other hand, is our backup sack outlet, but it's also really important because we have Shred Memory as one of our primary tutors in the deck. So Shred Memory can transmute for 3 mana to get something that costs 2 mana, which means we can get either of our Zubera, so to start off the combo, Floating Dream Zubera, but as the game goes along, Ember Fist Zubera to kill our opponent, or our Bloodthrown Vampire, so it gets both halves of our combo eventually. So how do we actually combo off with these Zuberas and with our sack outlets? Well, first, to make it work, we need a bunch of extra mana. So as we're sacking our Zubera, scrying through our deck, we're looking for enough mana to basically keep the combo going. So for this, we have Lotus Petals, Dark Rituals, Cabal Rituals, and Calling the Weak, which is especially sweet because it kind of does double duty. Not only does it add 4 mana for 1 mana, so plus 3 mana, it also lets us sack a creature, and we actually actively want to be sacking our Zubera. So for example, we can sacrifice our Floating Dream Zuberas, add 4 mana to our mana pool, and we get to draw cards from it dying. Cabal Ritual can add up to 5 mana if we have Threshold, Dark Ritual plus 2 mana, Lotus Petal plus 1 mana, but all these cards just help make sure we have mana to keep casting our spells, because we need to cast a lot of spells in one turn if we're actually going to combo off and win. So how do we actually win with this deck? And this is where it gets pretty sweet. So the Storm aspect of this deck involves using cards like Supernatural Stamina and Undying Evil to keep getting the same Zubera back from the graveyard. So let's run through a super quick example here. Let's say we have Floating Dream Zubera, we have our Viserysir, and we untap, we cast Supernatural Stamina, targeting our Floating Dream Zubera. So Supernatural Stamina will make it so when the Floating Dream Zubera dies, it comes back into play. Undying Evil basically does the same thing. So we cast that, then we just sack Floating Dream Zubera to our Viserysir. We get to scry, Floating Dream Zubera comes back into play. The cool thing is we don't have to let that draw trigger resolve right away. Instead, we can immediately sack the Floating Dream Zubera again with the first draw card equal to the number of Zuberas that die trigger on the stack, which is going to leave us with 2 triggers on the stack. So instead of drawing 1 card, coming back, drawing 1 card, we're going to have 2 triggers that are each going to see 2 dead Zuberas, so they're each going to draw 2 cards, which is 4 cards. But then it gets even crazier. Like, let's say we added some mana with our rituals, we can cast an Undying Evil, and then we're drawing not 4 cards, 2 and 2, if we do the same trick where we sack in response, leave the triggers on the stack, we're going to be drawing 3 times 3 cards. Each trigger will be 3 cards. there's three on the stack, that's nine cards. That is a lot of Zuberas going to the graveyard, a lot of cards drawn. So that's kind of plan one. And you notice both Supernatural Stamina and Undying Evil are only one mana. So a single Dark Ritual lets us cast these cards twice. A Calling the Weak lets us cast three of these cards. But if that's not enough, we have some backup plans. Unearth and Exhume give us additional ways to get our Zuberas back from the graveyard. So these don't combo quite as well because we can't do the trigger on the stack trick because they're sorcery speed. But still, let's say we drew four cards. We sacked the Zubera with a Supernatural Stamina, came back in, sacked it again, we drew four cards, we draw into our Unearth, then we simply get back Floating Dream Zubera, we sack it again. This time, we had two Zuberas die already, so it'll be drawing us three cards, and hopefully, as we're drawing those cards, we're drawing more Calling the Weeks, we're drawing more mana production, we're drawing more Unearths and Exhumes to keep getting them back. So we just cycle through our entire deck, and then eventually, at the end of all this, we'll find our Emberfist Zubera, because we're going to draw, like, essentially our entire deck, and then we just do the same thing. We Emberfist Zubera, we sack it. By that time, we're probably hitting for 5 damage, 7 damage, 8 damage. We use our Unearths, we use our Supernatural Staminas, our Undying Evils to get it back, do it again. Two or three Emberfist Zuberas at that point, after drawing our entire deck, should be enough to just close out the game and win us the game straight up. As far as the mana base, we have a bunch of dual lands, Ash Barrens, Evolving Wilds, Dismal Backwater, Demir Guildgate, some basic lands. In the sideboard, Ashen Skin Zubera comes into fight control. Not really as good at comboing, but it's still a Zubera. Can potentially just wipe out our opponent's hand if they're holding counters and stuff like that. Duress also gets rid of removal, gets rid of graveyard hate. Gushot, Nausea, Echoing Truth, more removal on our side. And then pieces of the puzzle, just to generate some value, kind of a 2-for-1 against control decks to fight through disruption. And that is Zubera Storm for Pop. Just keep sacking those Zuberas. Hopefully it works out. And that's been our instant deck tech for today. So thanks again to Storm for sending in the Sweet Fishbowl Thursday deck. Again, a reminder, send in your own list. Leave them in the comments. Email me, SaffronOlive@mtggoldfish.com. You could get it covered as a future Fishbowl Thursday deck. Again, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will talk to you soon. Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.